Today, the governor's office revealed 21 places across the state that the New York State Board of Historic Preservation is recommending be added to the state and national registers of historic places.
And four of them are right in the city of Buffalo. Two on your side's Kelly Dudzik shows us where they are and takes us inside one building that's undergoing a major restoration.
We're going to have 19 apartments located on the second floor and then four on the first floor.
Shea Seneca in South Buffalo is in the heart of the Seneca Street commercial corridor. Schneider Development is busy transforming it into a mixed-use space.
This right here is going to be the future home of Public Espresso. Two gentlemen that are South Buffalonians.
We had Matt Hartrich, the VP of Development, show us around. While the theater was demolished decades ago, the lobby and space next to it are still standing. Much of this will become banquet space. This used to be Woolworth's, and upstairs where the apartments are being built was the Sky Room, which hosted legendary concerts.
That was one of the criterion that it was listed on the National Register for, was its importance in the social fabric of the community.
Michael Shea built Shea's Seneca. The lobby is being restored by Switek Studios, a local company that also restored the North Park and Shea's Buffalo. And that's important because architectural significance is also a requirement to land on a state or national register. Shea's Seneca is just one of four Buffalo buildings to make the cut.
This is the Kreiner Malt House and Grain Elevator on Elk Street in Buffalo. And if you're a beer lover, it was a very important place. It provided a lot of the malt to local breweries last century. This is the old Phoenix Brewing Company on Washington Street in downtown Buffalo. It was built in the late 1800s, and part of it has already been transformed into new apartments. And the fourth building is Temple Beth Zion on Delaware Ave. Known for its stained glass, it was built in the mid-1960s.
Getting onto a register can help property owners revitalize buildings by making them eligible for preservation programs, including state and federal historic tax credits. Hartrich says those tax credits have been key to making it feasible for developers to restore buildings in Buffalo. He's excited to see what's next for Seneca Street.
There's a lot of historical significance as to what happened in this building, and then, hopefully again in the future.
The Shea Seneca building is expected to reopen August 1st. 21 places from across the state made the list. You can check it out by clicking on this story on WGRZ.com. Kelly Dudzik, Channel 2 News.